Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. I am so happy that you're here. If you're new here, welcome. Hi, my name is Tina. I am a 53-year-old woman who's interested in beauty, skincare, shopping hauls, subscription boxes, and all things to do with my home. If those are things that interest you as well, I hope you'll please subscribe. I would love to have you join me as well. And this is just a reminder that I do have an Instagram page set up and I have it linked below in the description box. It's all one word, Tina's Best Midlife without the apostrophe. I would love it if you would follow me on there and then I can follow you as well. Like I've said, so many of you I feel like I'm becoming friends with, and I think this will be a nice way that to be in touch on just a more regular basis. So if you'd like to follow me over there, I would love it. In today's video, I wanted to share with you some recent favorite items that I've purchased. I had initially set out to make a faves and fails video, but when I looked over all the things that I have been using lately, they were overwhelmingly favorites and no fails, which I think is kind of a good thing. So let's just jump right into it. I will show you some of my recent favorite things that I have been loving. The first thing that I wanted to show you that has become a recent favorite are these really cute little booties that I picked up from Kohl's. These are the So brand, and they are in the color Cognac. Did I say that right? I don't know, it sounds funny. I'll get closer, you can kind of see. They're, I guess, like, maybe you'd say it's like a faux suede. I have only had these a few weeks and only been able to wear them one day. It's been really mild where I live and it really hasn't been sweater and boot season yet, but we did have one like chilly day and I wore these and loved them. I think the color is so cute that they will go with so many, you know, sweaters and tops that I have. And I like the height, which is good for like crop jeans, or I think it's a really good height. They do have the zipper in and out, and they also have this little elastic part over here that just keeps it like really comfortable. And the day that I wore these, they weren't rubbing against that skin above my ankle, which sometimes happens. And they do have a memory foam insole, which makes them super comfortable. I love the heel height. I love how they look, but even more importantly, I love how comfortable they are. A normal price for these is $49.99. They happened to be on sale the day that I was there for $39.99. And then lucky me, I had a 30% off coupon. So I snatched these up and I'm so happy that I did. I just think they're so cute and I think they'll be great. I'll be wearing these all fall and winter. And sometimes people think like, oh, you know, boots like that, they're you know, inexpensive and they're not gonna last very long. Well, I will show you these booties that I bought, the same So brand from Kohl's. And these are over 3.5 years old. Still wear these all the time. They are holding up wonderfully, as you can see. And I still think these are cute. I think it'll be nice to have a different height and style. But just if you were worried how this brand wears, like I said, these are over 3.5 years old and they're still hanging on strong. So I was so happy to find these little booties. One thing I will let you know is that I normally take a size 10, and when I was at the store and I tried the 10 on, they were really slipping at my heel. So I actually bought these in a 9.5. So I think that they may run a little bit bigger than normal. So if you were shopping online, you may want to go a half size down is what I have found for these. But so excited to have these and I wanted to share these with you. Okay, one of my next favorite things recently is this new book that I got. It is called Coffee Self-Talk by Kristen Helmsetter. It's 5 minutes a day to start living your magical life. And I purchased this off of Amazon. I'll go ahead and link it below. But I am generally a very positive person. I'm definitely a half full type of gal. But I have found out that sometimes I can hear the inner dialogue and the things that I say to myself are not all that positive and can be, you know, negative. And I'm really trying to get away from that. This is a great book to kind of get you started on a ritual of coffee in the morning and positive self-talk. And I don't know, some of you may think it's a little woohoo or whatever, but I do believe that the things that we tell ourselves over and over again, they do become our truths. And if you can reprogram and, you know, get those negative thoughts out of your head that you say to yourself, sometimes even subconsciously, you don't even, you know, realize that you're doing it, but that inner dialogue can be negative and it helps no one. So I'm really enjoying this book. I'm not completely done, almost there, but I've already started the ritual of having my coffee, taking those 5 minutes to, you know, come up with my own affirmations, or, you know, there's some in the book, obviously, that you can use, but just choosing in the morning to go down a path of having a good day by really enforcing all those positive, you know, self quotes and self talk that we hear we should do, but sometimes we don't. So I think this is a great book. I'm really happy I purchased it. I think there is like a little journal that goes with it that I may look into as well. But if you're looking for something to kind of get you started on a path of really enforcing that positive self talk, this one is really good. Okay, the next item, or I should say items, that I wanted to show you are these face and eye palettes that I ordered from Laura Geller. And they come in this cute little box. And it's these three palettes here. I have been eyeing these when I have been on her website the last few times, and then got that email saying, you know, 20% off the entire site. And I was like, oh, it's meant to be. I need to get these. So I snatched these up and I am so glad I did. To say that I have been loving these is kind of an understatement. I have been obsessed with these palettes. Let me show you the great colors. This first one is called Flower District, and this is the one I thought for sure was going to be my favorite. Look at those pretty colors. Look at the blush and the highlighter. And I do love this. I've been wearing this a lot. I thought when I looked at the website that this one I would not be wearing. I might gift it to a friend. And I am so surprised. This is actually the blush and highlighter that I'm wearing today. I didn't think I would be able to wear this shade of blush, but I think it's one of those things that these colors look good on every skin tone. So loving this one here as well. And then the last one is called Central Park. And once again, I can wear that blush, and I'm actually wearing today these eyeshadows, the shade Belvedere Castle and Cherry Hill, these two here. And I'll just zoom in so you can see. I think they're really pretty eyeshadows. So I'm enjoying like mixing, you know, a blush from one and eyeshadows from another. And I loved the idea of these that if you were going away for just like an overnight or a weekend, that you could pack one of these, and you could pack her like Baked Balance and Brighten foundation, which is in a powder form, and a mascara and a lipstick, and you could be done. So I think they'll be great for traveling, but I have just been loving using these. I just think they're all so pretty. They did come, so it was these three, but it also came with this really great eyeshadow brush. It's got a very long handle, and I love the length of the bristles. I have very small hooded eyes, so sometimes eyeshadow brushes can be way too long for me. You know, I'm going to trying to apply eyeshadow like mostly on my lid, and because the brush is so big, it can go everywhere. This is a really good size brush, really soft, really nice brush. And then it also came with this mascara, Love Your Body Volumizing Mascara, which I have yet to try, but I'm excited because I have to say most of the Laura Geller products I really enjoy. These are really great little palettes. One of my next favorite items that I have been enjoying so much is this hand soap from Bath & Body Works, and it's in the scent Marshmallow Fireside. If you've been into Bath & Body Works at this time of year, you probably know that they have a candle called Marshmallow Fireside, and I have smelled it myself, and it smells really interesting. It's kind of got like a sweet and smoky, woodsy scent, which is exactly what this soap smells like. But I don't know about you, but sometimes those Bath & Body Works candles, I know so many people really enjoy them, but I can find them really strong. I love candles that are more in the background. I want to be able to smell it, obviously, but I like them when they're more in the background and not like knocking you over the head with the scent like the minute you walk in or giving you a headache type of thing. So I really don't burn the Bath & Body Works candles just because I do find them too strong. But when they had this scent in the soap, I snatched it up, and it is just, like I said, a really kind of unique scent because it's kind of got the sweet with the marshmallow, but it's got a little like back note of smokiness and like woodsiness. It's just really, really a neat fragrance that I've been enjoying just in a hand soap, because then it's not overpowering, it's not overwhelming, but you can still enjoy the scent. So I've had this in my powder room and really enjoying this Bath & Body Works Marshmallow Fireside soap. Another favorite that I've recently come across is a makeup primer, and this is called the Blur to Perfection. And I actually got this at Five Below. I don't know if you have any Five Belows near you, but obviously everything in the store is $5 or under. And I was just kind of browsing around in there, saw this, and you know what gets me every time is this blurring. Like, you know, it's just gonna blur out all the wrinkles and flaws, which we know it doesn't do. But this really surprised me. It is in the little dropper form, and I have to tell you, my dropper does not work at all. I have to smear it onto my fingers and apply it that way. I don't know if I just got a bad one or if they're all like that, but my dropper does not work. But this primer, what I found is that I just kind of smear it all over my hands, apply it, and you really don't have much play time when you're applying this primer. It really sets very quickly, but I think that's one of the reasons that it just makes your makeup really grip to it, go on very easily, very smoothly, and last a long time. If you are in the market for an inexpensive face primer that you have a Five Below near you that you can get to, give this a try. I really like it, and now I will probably go back and even maybe try. They had different formulas for the primer, but this one is really good, and I wouldn't be at all nervous to try any of the other ones. So I'm really liking this Blur to Perfection face primer from Five Below. And the last thing that I have been enjoying, and this is just kind of like a sweet treat, I picked up recently the Trader Joe's Apple Blossoms. I'm in a little two-pack of these apple blossoms. You take them out of the freezer, plop them on a cookie sheet, and they heat up in like 20 to 25 minutes. It could not be easier. And I was so shocked at how much I enjoyed these apple blossoms. I guess I'm kind of a snob when it comes to apple pie because I love homemade apple pie. I mean, there's probably nothing better in the fall than a slice of apple pie. But whenever I've purchased a store-bought or even a bakery apple pie, I am always disappointed. I don't know if it's the texture of the apples or just there's something about them that I don't like. So when I tried these, I was kind of expecting that it was gonna be, you know, the kind of that store-bought taste apple pie. Oh my gosh, it's not. These are delicious, delicious. I made this package the other night for my husband and I, and he agreed that they are awesome. I like to top them with a little bit of vanilla ice cream or whipped cream just to make it even that much more delicious. But if you have a Trader Joe's near you, go and give these apple blossoms a try for just a, you know, a little decadent treat some night on a fall night when you just want a little something that's, you know, warm and comforting and delicious. I love these. So those are all the things that I have recently purchased that I have been loving that have instantly become favorites. I really hope that you enjoyed this video. I always find these so much fun to make. And thank you so much for being here and for watching. I appreciate you all, and I will see you next time. Bye.